Stress is an avoidable part of our modern system. Even the children also, they do have stress, and even a retired person also do have a stress. Iyengar yoga teaches us exactly how to deal with these stresses in a different level, from the child, school going children, until the old people. Not only Iyengar yoga teaches how to deal with the stress, but also Iyengar yoga helps us to cope up with the stress and to increase the capacity of the bearing of the stress and to fight with it by taking into consideration the whole family. Old man, if he is suffering with the stress, Iyengar yoga makes him quiet with relaxed postures so that he can become calm, he can become quiet. But at the same time, school or college going children, if they are going under the stress, Iyengar yoga helps them to increase their capacity to bear the stress and increase their strength to fight with it. Nowadays we come across a lot of women, those are homemakers, they also find a lot of stress at the time when they are body changing, about 40-45 year lady who is alone at home because her children are busy, her husband is busy, and she is facing the menopause problem where a lot of psychological effect comes. So she doesn't have the stress of driving the car or going to the office or the office boss, but as a homemaker she has got a lot of stress, and Iyengar yoga with a different kind of a gynec postures when it is given to that lady, she is more relaxed. Spinal cord is called as the nervous system where the merudanda is there. So we have to keep the merudanda very strong, firm and strong, very strong all the time. When we take the birth, that time for a while we need the support for the spine because the baby cannot hold the neck, so we support the entire baby like that. But in our rest of the life we pray to the God that there should not be any time in our life where we should need the support for the spine. In fact, the spine should all the time throughout our life should support our body, which is supporting the mind through the nervous system. So Iyengar yoga helps not only to relax but to strengthen the spine and the nervous system in a different way. For a simple pose like Uttanasana, we are bending down, and when you are coming upward, you are supposed to keep the leg straight. That means we are strengthening the spine to come up by itself. We are not eligible to support the spine. We pray to the God that we should not give the support of the spine, but our spine should be giving the support to us throughout the life. Many times with the over flexible body, many people makes a lot of problem, in the sense that we call it a soft spine. If we come across a small girl or a boy below 8 years old and being very flexible, we do not tell them to become more and more flexible. In fact, we tell them not to do certain poses, like if they are doing a very good back arch, we stop them. Because the children, we all are born with the flexible spine. Our work is to strengthen the spine at that age. So we have to strengthen the spine at the lower age, like the school children. But thereafter, once we become old, the spinal cord, the spinal muscles become stiff. So that is the time where we have to make them supple, where we have to make them flexible. Breath is the part where it reaches everywhere. So breath with body, breath with mind is continuously is a flow which helps a human being to survive in the best possible way. It so happens that when we are under stress, that means the mind is under stress, we don't know how much we are breathing. In fact, we don't even know whether we are breathing or not. Isn't it? So that is a correlation. When the mind becomes stressed, we really forget to breathe. The breathing goes on the autonomous system. Like for example, you are driving on the busy street, or when you are in the front of 3-4 bosses and you are working when the deadline is closer. That time, how is the breath? It's very short breath, which doesn't give the mind to open up like that. We can work nicely by paying the attention to the breath. Now God has given us such a capacity, nice capacity for our lungs. We have to welcome that pranavayu inside. So with the when you are inhaling, don't think that we are inhaling just breath inside, but we say that it is a pranavayu which is you are taking it inside. So welcome it well and your mind will be certainly relaxed. So first, before relating with the breath and the mind, find out how much and how we are breathing, have the knowledge of that, then we can find out how it is related with the body physically, how the breath is helpful for the physiological part of the body, then comes the mind. But many times we are so much stressed with the mind, so the mind comes first. So let change your position. Instead of you are sitting all the time in a stressful position, be in a Purva Pratan pose where you are expanding the eastern side and get the breath inside. The mind has got the tremendous amount of changes immediately. Well, that's a big question and is very difficult to answer because we are all the time too much pulled by the mind. And many times we don't listen to our body. So many times it goes on because always Guruji used to say, the mind always in past. But unfortunately, the body always in future. So we have to correlate that in a proper way. If you start asking the person, how are you and all those things, I want to know about you, he will tell you everything regarding the past. I was this much, I had done like that. Then if you ask me, what are you doing now? Now we will say that now it is very difficult for me to do it because my body is becoming older. Once you realize that, then it will be fine. Otherwise, it is like you are going for a trek. 8 years boy is going to the trek with 80 years person. The boy is pulling and pulling and pulling. That old person wants to go, but he cannot go because of his physical conditions. So mind and body, we have to have the symmetry in a proper way. Anyone who comes across saying that early morning, as soon as I open my eyes, I am very fresh. And I am very fresh mentally till late night. That is good in one way, but certainly bad in the other way. Because that time the body needs the relaxation. It has been decided by the nature, not with us. Many times the people, they tell us, no, I work till late night. My mind is fresh like early morning. Unfortunately, these people are physically going towards the illness. And then in that case, the mind is pulling the body. So mind has a great work to be fresh, but at the same time, the mind should listen to the body. Therapeutic healing practice is one of the branch of Iyengar Yoga. We have to study each and every Guruji's picture in a proper way. And then only you will realize how Guruji has done not only a physical form of any of the pose, not only physiological, but also psychological and spiritual level. We need a guide to see Guruji's pictures. They only see the outer form of it, and then they only try to perform only the outer kind of the pose, which looks like an exercise. But I'll tell you one secret, that if you'll see Guruji's pictures, poses, every pose Guruji's face is in Shavasana. That we nobody realizes. Every pose Guruji's foot is in Sama Sthiti. Equal weight, Sama, even. So everywhere is even in that. That nobody realizes. Yes, we have to begin with the physical body at the beginning. In order to know exactly from where to start, we have to start from the known body. Then only we can go to semi-known, and then only we can go towards the unknown, which is kind of a mind. But suppose if you start regarding the mind, then it's a clear-cut failure. In Iyengar Yoga, we tell you to just relax the palm. Now, what is palm? What is the hand? The hand is not just the hand. Hand we have, it is so much sensitive that whatever we feel to the palm, to the fingers, that goes to the brain. So hand and the palm is directly related. So when we say that when you are doing Shavasana or when you are doing the resting poses, relax the arm first, not the head first. That is okay. Many people think that this is a physical form of yoga. But in order to break the outer shell, to go more and more inside, we have to first go through the outer body to go inside. From where to go to the outer body? That is the gross physical body, that is the palms, that is the hands. Have you seen a person who is under stress? His hands are like Shavasana? No, their hands are like this. A depressed person, the hands are like this. The shoulders, they come up. A depressed person is like this. Okay, that is a nervous person will move the hands, unnecessary movements. So we relax the hands first. When the hands are relaxed, then only we can relax physiologically as well as we can relax the mind. Yoga will give you a perfect balance between balancing yoga, your personal life, your family life, your social life, like that. What Guruji used to say, just do yoga and everything will follow to you in a proper way. And personally, that has happened in my life and my colleague's life. Guruji just said, do yoga. I can give you my example. When I was in college, I never thought of becoming a teacher and all those things. It just happened. Guruji called me to teach, Gitaji called me to teach, and it just happened. And I'm happy that I'm able to pursue it like that. And I've seen my colleagues from the Iyengar Institute as well as from my institute, when they start doing yoga, then there is no complaint from the family, and they can, when they are just doing yoga, the balance can be formed to the great extent, because in that case the body is more balanced, the mind is quite balanced with the help of Iyengar yoga. So I don't feel that any problem in the balancing the life, really. So yoga, according to Guruji, is a way of life. So when you follow the yoga, everything will certainly comes to you, and it balances in a perfect way.